I shall now be talking about a little bit about the properties of secondary memory and later on explaining a secondary memory device called as the hard disk, a very high level view of how the hard disk works and how data is stored. So the secondary memory is also known as auxiliary memory or external memory. One thing which differentiates the primary memory from the secondary memory is the secondary memory is much slower than the primary memory by a factor of hundreds of times. But there's a major advantage with the secondary memory. The programs, instructions, and data which are not being currently used, or if you have to store data for long-term use, you will basically put it in the secondary memory. In fact, all programs and data which are not currently being used by the CPU will always reside in the secondary memory. It has got a very huge capacity. For example, the laptop I am using has a capacity of 512 gigabytes. It's a solid state drive, whereas my main memory or the RAM is just 8 GB. So you can keep expanding the secondary memory as much as you want based on the need. Now the cost per unit of storage is much cheaper for the secondary memory compared to the main memory or the RAM. Say for example, the other day I inquired what will be the cost of 8 GB of RAM for my Asus TUF gaming laptop. They said it will be around 3500 to 4000. Around that price you will get a good hard disk of around 1 TB. So that is the price difference between a hard disk and a main memory. Now one thing should be very clear, the CPU cannot utilize the contents of the secondary memory directly. It has to first be loaded into the main memory or the RAM, and then only the CPU can use the contents of the secondary memory. Now the major advantage of secondary memory is data can be stored for a very long time. They are highly stable, reliable, and do not depend upon the power supply for storage. So data is basically permanent. For example, CDs and DVDs can last hundreds of years unless you modify, delete, erase, or change. Examples of secondary devices are hard disk, CDs, DVDs, pen drives are all excellent examples of secondary memory devices. Now what I shall do is, I shall use this opportunity to just tell you a little bit about the hard disk, which is the most common secondary memory used either in your laptops or your PC. So one thing you need to understand with the hard disk is something like this. Hard disk can be thought as a series of circular plates. This is all an example of one plate. So you can have 8, 10, 12 plates. Okay, on the 10-12 plates at the center there is a spindle. Because of this spindle, all the plates are held in one place and the plates rotate around this particular spindle. Now this plate is coated with magnetic media both on the top and lower side of the plate. So every plate is coated with magnetic media at the top and bottom. This plate in technical terms is known as a platter. Alright, now this material, the platter material, is either made up of aluminium or it is made up of thin high quality glass or plastic material. Then in order to read and write data from this particular plates, you have something called as the read-write head. The read-write head has got an actuator axis, which will be clear in the next diagram. At the end it's got a head. The head is used to read and write data from this hard disk. The head is on both the top part of the plate as well as the bottom part of the plate. Now, if you see, there are a number of dots here. So what this is this is known as the IDE or the data cable. Somewhere data has to be transported from the hard disk onto your computer's different parts. So using this IDE cable, you will plug it in here, okay, and then the other part of the cable goes on the motherboard and they are able to communicate with the motherboard. This is the power connector or the power slot for the hard disk drive, because hard disk also needs power to run because it's an electromechanical device. In order to understand the data storage and the partitioning of the platter, it is excellent to take a look at this particular diagram. So you can think of this magnetic platter as consisting of a number of running tracks which are parallel to each other. So this is track 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. This red color fellow is an example of one single track. Okay. So now if you look at this B, B represents a group of something called as sectors. But before that, let's take a look at C. C represents between this partition, if you see this pinkish part, this C represents the sector of a given track. So this is known as a sector. Just this part will be the sector, this part will be the sector. Now what I have done is on the same track, I have taken 1, 2 and 3. So there are 3 sectors on this particular track. So I hope this gives you an idea of how the information is stored. It is stored in terms of sectors and tracks. Now one more diagram, the geometrical diagram, which gives you an idea of the hard disk geometry, will give you a complete idea of the working of the hard disk. So this yellow fellow is the track. This red fellow is the track sector. Now what happens is, if you look at the track here, all these tracks, tracks will be above as well as they'll be below. Okay. So the track below this, then this track and the track below this, track this and the track below this, all are referred to as a cylinder. So what happens is, if you look at this read-write head, this head cannot go here, this head cannot go here, and this head cannot go here. All the heads will be at the same place on all the tracks and sectors. So designers are smart. In order to speed up reading and writing, they try to store it along the same track in each of the platters. That means the information, if it is on this platter, it will be exactly below that in the platter below, it will be on the same track. Since the data is stored on the same track on each of this hard disk, both on the top and below, using the read write head, since it stays at one position for all the tracks, sorry, for all the platters, you can read and write faster. So that is the design geometry. Now on this aluminium plate or glass fiber material, you have magnetic layer coated, and then you have an electromagnet which basically forms the read write head. Using the electromagnet, there is a gap between the material and the electromagnet, and as the head moves, looking at the polarity, whether it's north or south, it interprets the bit as ones or zeros, and that's how data is analyzed or read for or written from the hard disk. So I believe this should give you a wonderful idea about the working of the hard disk. Now, before I say thank you, I would like to thank the people at Wikimedia Commons for making all these wonderful diagrams available to us by just allowing us to cite them and without any copyright restrictions on their usage. With this, I'd like to say goodbye to all of you.